Okay, now here's the way I heard the story about you two, okay? I hear one day Dad was about 21 years old, and someone asked him when he was going to settle down and get married, and he pointed across the backyard to Mom and said, "I'm waiting for her to grow up." Is that story even remotely true?
Yeah, I'm still waiting.
Is that the true story?
Something similar. I was babysitting for Aunt Francie, taking care of Marty and Ricky in a tent up in front of Aunt Francie's house. And Dad came up, I suppose to see Aunt Francie, I don't know, when he came in the tent and sat in there. And when he went out, Aunt Francie said something about us getting married. And he says, "Well, I'll wait for her to grow up." That's about it.
Mom loved being Mom. It was a full-time job for her, and believe me, we could be a full-time job.
Kids were little dolls, so you really were.
Did you originally want to make five children?
Not really,
no,
but it happened.
It just sort of came one at a time.
Yeah, well, that's for sure. If I'd had twins somewhere along the line, I really would have been in the nut house.
Oh, yes.
How many kids did you think you guys would have? Did you ever think, I mean, did you ever, I don't know.
You mean if we'd planned it?
No, not because if you'd have planned it, you've never had any.
No, we talked about four boys.
No. At that time, the Catholic Church didn't, if you were even a halfway Catholic, you believed in birth control. There's a rhythm boy right there. The rhythm section.
Still got pregnant.
Yeah. But if there's one thing she loved more than being a mother, it was being a grandmother.
Be careful.
The wheels on the bus go round and around, around and around.
Oh!
Grandma gave Sarah a bath tonight.
I think Sarah gave Grandma one too, but that's all right. For lots of things.
And if there's one thing she loved more than being a grandmother, it was being a great-grandmother. She also had a real love for her family's history, and there was nothing quite like looking through old photo albums with her.
Oh, Mom and Dad. Wow. What is this? This is
your great grandfather in his stone quarry in Arkansas.
Oh my gosh, there are Okies in there, not Okies, but real life hillbillies in my family.
Whenever I'd come home for a visit, Mom's was always one of the first faces I saw, and usually one of the last faces I'd see when I left. When Jean and I got married back in 1982, Mom and Vic rode a Greyhound bus for 12 hours all the way to Milwaukee just to be here. And when my niece Jessie and her husband Rhodey tied the knot in Port Charlotte, Florida back in 2007, Mom flew down all by herself just to be a part of it. And despite being 70 years old and walking with a cane, we could barely keep her off the dance floor.
If you see a painted sign at the side of the road that says 15 miles...
In 2004, we flew her and Dad up to Milwaukee for a week.
Glad to be here.
Which was not only a chance to show off our home, but it was also a long overdue opportunity to introduce them to Jean's mom and dad. Then, a few years later, she and Dad worked with Jean to give me a birthday surprise I will never forget.
Come on in.
Happy birthday!
Oh my God, I don't believe it! Can you stay for dinner?
But I think my favorite times with Mom and with Dad were times I had alone with them, grabbing lunch together, cooking together, or sharing a meal.
But I never could tell what's mine.
loved visiting Aunt Fran with Mom. They really had a special bond. There was nothing quite like taking her down to the farmer's market on the square, watching how quickly she gathered a crowd of friends. From the inside out, a slow turning, baby. But you come about. I also loved exploring Worcester with Mom and sharing stories and memories about the old neighborhoods.
What?
Delivering newspapers.
Yeah.
I was going to say, delivering the. I think it was
but you know what? Paper. You know, I called it my paper route, but it was really your paper route because you were the one who got up every Sunday morning with me and drove me around so I could toss the papers on the porches.
I used to practically live at that house. Aunt Ruby had, and Uncle Deck lived there.
What about this house here?
This house here?
Yeah. Does that it look smaller than you remember it?
Not really.
This was the
that
little
was
apartment that,
house.
Well,
that was
I
our
don't know about a honeymoon. You had two kids in that house, didn't you? And
I
a
had
third
three.
On the way?
No, Annette was born when we lived here.
Is that right? You
That's
had three
right.
kids?
In
there only, there's only like a bedroom and a half in there. 324 Barden Street. Dad built the house. You raised a family there. What do you think when you're in this neighborhood? How's it make you feel?
A little bit nostalgic, but not too bad. I tried to think to myself while we're moving on.
You got me because you grew up also right here.
Nice, yeah.
Dad grew up here, and then
it didn't look like this. Then.
You know, about 50 years of your life are all like right here on this street, aren't they?
I moved here in 46, and your dad was born at that house.
We were talking about some of the songs that who wrote them. My great grandfather would it have been?
Your great grandfather used to play these for me with his guitar.
Yeah, my great-grandfather, that would be your grandfather.
Yeah.
Okay. Now, you're going to sing the Robin song for us? This is a song that you sang to me when I was...
I think he wrote this one. Okay. I'm not sure about the 20 Froggies, but I think he wrote this one.
Okay.
It goes, oh, I saw a robin deer in a tree, and he sang a little song just for me. Oh, he sang a little song, but he did not sing it long, for the wind was blowing strong as could be, and
far away, out of sight, where the snow was falling down, thick and white. Oh, it blew him far away,
and I did not care to play any more at all that day until night. And that night I said my prayers by my bed. I remembered what in church once was said, how God listens to each word. So I told him of the bird, and I'm very sure he heard what I said, for the snow soon went away, and at dawn, little Robin hopped about on the lawn. Oh, he sang a jubilee in the crooked apple tree, for the winter, don't you see, it was gone.
Love that song. It makes me want to hug you because it's like a song you used to sing to me when I was a baby.
You better believe it I sang to you.
We were just listening to it on the video.
You were?
Oh, yeah, but Jason heard it. We were showing Jason that video.
What do you think, JC? Oh, no, he's going to grab the camera again.
Yeah, and if there's one thing you can say about Mom, it's that she loved being Mom. And despite occasional devastating physical challenges, she did it every day of her wonderful life.
It's such a nice day, even Mom's in the water. You okay? You look like maybe just the tide came in and kind of washed you out.
If I thought I wouldn't do damage to this thing, I'd be right in there swimming.
Oh, good. You look comfortable anyway.
I'm very comfortable.
All right. Well, what about you, Mom? What's different for you since last year?
Since last year, I got new glasses. And these do not turn in the sun.
Oh, I didn't realize your other ones did.
Yeah, but fortunately, I had to save them.
And I see, look at you, you're walking, you're not even using
a cane. I'm walking without my cane, but look at my legs, they're all swollen.
But now when you go for a walk out in the neighborhood, cane or no cane? You do take your cane?
Because the ground is so...
What are you looking at me for? What did I do? Courtney? Where are you? Courtney?
Now you can push it up against you in the
corner of the house. You can get her to... Hey, Courtney. You want an olive? Look here, Court. You want this? You're welcome.
Oh, yeah.
I suppose you want another one. Put your finger out.
He would know. He did that much for you.
Go show that to Uncle Steve.
There is a video I found from back when I was 3. You set up a pink set in the kitchen and you're talking to me. It's the age of princesses and pirate ships and the 7 dwarfs. And daddy's smart and you're the prettiest lady in the whole wide world. Now I know why all the trees change in the fall.